I want to talk about Chrome versus Windows versus Mac. And this is like the big one. If you're a business owner and you're concerned about cost or security, and you're interested in a smarter way of working with your machines, well, consider ChromeOS. This is really the best way to keep your machines integrated with your Google Workspace account. And ChromeOS is a great way for business owners and consumers to work. Now, the reason that I'm presenting this is customers come to us all the time and they say, hey, I'm using everything in the Google world and I'm thinking about a Chromebook, but I just don't know whether or not it's going to work and what things I might miss about my Windows machine, what things I might miss about my Mac. And so this video, I'm going to try and cover most of the things that I know that are the most obvious reasons that you would pick working with some of the different operating systems that you have access to. Now, myself personally, I switched to a Chrome device over 5 years ago and I never looked back. And this is a very different version of myself, where I actually had bought a Mac. I dropped nearly $5,000 on a Mac and I ended up taking it back and returning it to Apple because it really didn't do much more than an $800 Chromebook that I had at the time. And so I switched back to a Chromebook and basically I never went back from there. Now, interestingly, in the year 2020, Chromebooks have now just outsold Macs worldwide. And this is pretty darn interesting because previously it was known that they were already outselling in the education space. So Chromebooks were outselling other Mac computers and other machines in the space of education alone. But worldwide now, Chromebooks actually outsold Macs, which is pretty darn amazing. And so you can see the market share is now starting to shift. And to me, this kind of looks like the early days of Chrome as a web browser, which eventually went on to take over Firefox and take over Internet Explorer and then absolutely dominate. I think it's still about 60 to 70% of the total global browser market. So let's talk about some of the advantages to using Windows, some of the reasons why you may choose to work with a Windows operating system for your business environment or for yourself personally. Well, number one is the range of peripherals and the range of accessories. There are more things that work with Windows than work with other operating systems, and so you have more flexibility. I know myself personally, I do a lot of streaming online, and one of my streaming setups actually relies on a Windows-based computer because I use a bunch of input cards and they just don't work on Macs, or to run it on a Mac would be obscenely expensive because I'd have to buy a $15,000 Mac Pro. So that's one thing on the Windows count, but to be honest, because so many people have bought Macs in the last 10 years, most applications and most hardware peripherals now work with at least Macs as well, and Chromebooks have pretty darn good support for most peripherals too. The big one really for Windows though is integration with the rest of the Windows operating system and the Microsoft suite of tools. So if you're a business who's primarily relying on Microsoft Office and you like the Windows versions of those, that's probably going to be the one reason that's going to keep you in the Windows world. Now, personally, obviously, we're a company that uses Google, and so everything we do is in Google Drive and in Google Docs, and so we're just not really needing anything to do with the Microsoft system. But if you're someone who's really wedded to using your Outlook and you're not ready to make the switch over to Gmail, if you are, have a look at some of our other videos. We've got steps on that, but that's one of the reasons why you may choose to stick around. Next up for Windows is gaming, and Windows has a better range, it's more popular, better support for games, and just in general, better support for drivers on graphics cards. And so gaming is another reason why someone would really choose to stick with Windows as their primary machine. Now, there are pretty cool options coming to Macs. There's a Steam store on the Mac, and so a lot of games have been ported over to macOS because of the popularity on the consumer market. And also Google has released Google Stadia, which is a streaming platform which will stream down to Chromebook. So you do have options for games on Chrome and on Macs, but not quite as good as Windows. Now, one of the major downsides to Windows would be the version control. And this is the thing that really bugs me about Microsoft in general. Every couple of years, there's a new major version. And you know, this is true for Macs as well, but just not quite to the same extent of frustration. And what happens is you have to go through the big upgrade process. Same thing with Microsoft Office. Every couple of years, there's a new version that you've got to install and you've got to go through a whole upgrade process. Now, working in the Google world, we just don't have to worry about that. Chromebooks update every 4 to 6 weeks, and so they're always automatically on the latest version. Next up, you have things like your Google Docs and Google Drive, which are all just always running the latest version because Google runs them on the web. So you just never have to worry about anything happening with those. So they're the reasons you may choose Windows. Let's talk about some of the reasons you may choose a Mac.